to another episode of Razorback Reels. I'm your host, Kristen Bahls, and joining me on the panel today are...
I'm Jake Miller.
And I'm your co-host, Ambrosia Johnson.
And I'm Preston Smith.
So today's show is all about Netflix. And as if we needed another study distraction, Netflix is releasing some new shows in October. The first one is Supernatural. What do you guys think?
Season 11, it's got to be strong, right?
Yeah, I mean... They didn't get canceled, so I mean they're coming back.
I can't believe they've held it in so long. Like,
yeah,
11 seasons. That's
they're
like
getting
crazy.
Really creative, but I'm excited. I used to watch the show in its early days, and I can say I definitely will sit down and watch the 11th season.
All right, yeah, sounds pretty cool.
And then there's also Vampire Diaries, which I'm excited to watch this on Netflix, but we'll see in the new season because now Eleanor is gone. Don't know really how they're gonna do that, but I guess we'll find out.
Not really my thing. It's more of a show that my sister watches.
I'm not down with the vampire stuff anymore.
Yeah.
I'm over that.
I mean, I got into the Twilight thing, but...
I got into True Blood, and then I just dropped off because it got too cliche, too.
Yeah, it's pretty cheesy. And then the next is American Horror Story Freak Show.
Oh, yeah.
Very excited.
I'm ready for that.
Very excited.
For Halloween.
Recap on the Freak Show and, like, the creepy clowns
that,
like, freaked everybody out.
Yeah.
And as we're gearing up for Hotel, we'll just get to kind of... revisit Freak Show.
Yeah.
There's very few shows on TV that make you as uncomfortable as
that's definitely one of them.
And then there's also Batman Begins for the movies. I'm excited. I think it's a good one to rewatch.
I just can't wait till they put the second and third one up because
I can't say enough about the three of them. I just want to sit every night and watch all three of them.
Yeah.
Well, soon we'll be able to probably binge watch all of them. Now that will
good.
Be like,
that needs to happen.
That needs to happen.
You know, just watch them all.
And then Million Dollar Baby is another one to catch up on. I think it'll be a good one to rewatch. It's kind of a classic.
Yeah, a nice classic.
Heart
if you want to get depressed, it is a classic.
Yeah.
I agree with you on that.
Oh, yeah.
But, I mean, I stay away from red step stools, so.
Yeah. And also, there's going to be the Walt Disney Animated Short Film Collection. I'm excited. I always like watching these before the Disney movies, so I think it should be pretty good.
So if I'm not mistaken, are these like kind of like never-before-seen clips from popular Disney movies, kind of? Like maybe like Frozen or
there was a Frozen clip that played before Cinderella and it was so good. So I hope it's kind of stuff like that. I think that would be really interesting to watch and I would definitely find that on Netflix.
Yeah.
And then next for the new Netflix originals coming out, there is Hemlock Grove, which is the third and final season. This looks really intense. I mean, it is a horror thriller, so I think this is going to be a good one.
I agree. Eli Roth is really good at the horror genre, and he's producing this show, so especially if it's on Netflix, it's going to be really intense.
Yeah, I mean, like, American Horror Story makes me uncomfortable. Hemlock Grove is one of those shows.
It's like next level?
Yeah, it's kind of like X-Files, but it's really creepy small town vibe, so.
All right, I could get down with that.
Do you think it's going to have the blood levels of the rest of Eli Roth's work, or they might turn it down for TV?
Who knows? I mean, he definitely likes to go overboard with a little bit of extra blood here and there, but it will freak you out at least once or twice.
Just in time for Halloween.
And then there's Winter on Fire, which that seems pretty chilling.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, the Ukraine, that whole military conflict, that's still happening right now, so... I've seen a little bit of it. You can watch it online for free, and it's definitely intense.
It'll be interesting to get a historical perspective on something that's just happened.
Yeah.
Yes, like it's like, what, 2014 when it first started? Like,
I believe that
really got me was how recent it is.
It seems like it's so far away, but it really happened just a few months ago.
Hardly had any time for anything to happen after the revolt.
Right.
Yeah. And it being on Netflix just kind of really brings it even more to our attention, and I think it'll really kind of help get the word out about what's going on.
Yeah, just like in 2013, the Netflix documentary The Square about the Egyptian revolt, that helped a lot of people really understand the conflict and everything.
Right, yep.
And I mean, if Netflix kind of had a hand in it, I think it's going to be great.
Mm-hmm. And this Ukrainian conflict is extremely complex.
I heard a lot about like the camera crew. Like they had like hundreds of people like filming from different angles. They have like great footage of like all the violence. And we're going to be up close and personal with this conflict. And it's going to be pretty intense.
Yeah.
And then there's also Beast of No Nation, which that is going to be very, very chilling. It's about children soldiers. I mean, the trailer alone just got my heartstrings.
Yeah. Is it Idris Elba? I think he's going to put like a very, very like crazy spin. I mean, like, didn't he play like Nelson Mandela? He's played like some very intense.
Everything he does like, is characters. Extremely intense. He brings it every single time.
I mean, like, I don't think you could have a not intense movie with that storyline. It's so.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, should he be the new James Bond?
That is.
I would be happy to see that.
Yeah. I would love to see some. Like, I wouldn't say just diversity, but just a new spin. Like,
well,
I think
fresh.
He could add some,
he's
like,
British.
Coolness.
He's, you know, he has the swagger.
Yeah. Oh, definitely swag.
And, and I think, I think he could do some awesome action scenes.
With as many James Bond movies as there is, you're always trying to look for a new turn, a new twist.
Yeah.
I think this would be a good one.
And, I mean, if they can make an all-girl cast of Ghostbusters, I think that he could definitely make a good James Bond. Just kind of switch it up a little bit.
Yeah, but then we wouldn't have Daniel Craig anymore. Who is kind of on top of his game.
He is currently killing it.
When he goes down, we'll talk about Idris Elba.
All right.
And Angela Johnson is coming out with her homecoming show. I don't know about you guys, but her nail salon skit was all the rage in middle school.
She is so funny.
I haven't met someone that hasn't seen Bon Kui Kui. And that routine.
Bon Kui Kui at King Burger.
I'm surprised it's been this long since she's released her own special. I think she's a comedic genius.
Yeah. Are comedy specials a good idea for Netflix?
I think so.
It's a good spin to have like a nice, like, you know, comedic value to it. Just have like all these random, you know, stand-up specials. I mean, it kind of competes with like things like HBO and Showtime that premiere these big, like, you know, Kevin Hart, Cat Williams, you know, and to have Angela like Johnson be on there, like, that's just gonna
I
think the stand-up special has kind of been going away over the past couple years, so I think if Netflix starts to really get in the game, I think we could see a resurgence of stand-up specials.
Which I'm excited for. I really like stand-up.
I love stand-up comedy as well.
And it's just kind of a nice break from all the intense shows, like after you've watched Scandal or How to Get Away with Murder. You can just kind of relax with some comedy in your life.
Yeah, just watch 45 minutes of jokes.
Some good old-fashioned Louis C.K. or something.
Yeah.
Excellent.
And also there's Mr. Peabody and the Sherman Show, a little kids show in there for them. What do you guys think about that?
Interested.
Yeah, I mean, I think Chris Parnell is the voice of the dog.
Chris Parnell is hilarious.
That was pretty hilarious. Cool.
Yeah.
Eager to see how they're going to be getting kids involved with this. And
it's supposed to be a revamp of a 1960s cartoon, I believe I read.
Yeah.
Not so closely related to the movie.
But, I mean, I think I've seen a little bit of the trailer. I think it looks really funny. I mean, I'm not going to sit down and probably watch a lot of cartoons. But
it's cute.
But I definitely think if you guys have kids, I think it's going to be great. Maybe not as awesome as Frozen, but.
Nothing beats Frozen.
It's not fair, in my opinion.
And then there's also another stand-up special, Anthony Jeselnik, with his thoughts and prayers. What do you guys think?
Excited.
Yeah.
I've actually never heard of this guy, but watching a little bit of it, I'm kind of excited to see how he's going to tackle stand-up
comedy.
He's
extremely minimal, extremely dry.
But I think that's where like all of his like humor comes from.
It comes from the fact he's so dry that you almost don't expect the offensiveness that he brings.
He also has a lot of like self-deprecating humor, which, I mean, I make fun of myself all the time, so I find that funny. So
And his humor is completely different from Angela's, so I feel like it kind of brings a spin of different comedians. It's not like the same kind of thing.
Absolutely. She brings a Latino fire and he kind of scales it back a bit, takes it back home.
Yeah, and I'm happy they're coming out with new stuff. I feel like I've been watching Donald Glover and like Kevin Hart for a while.
We need some new in here.
Some fresh blood, and I think that's definitely what comedy needs.
And coming up next, we have another Razorback review from Sam Tyler.
Make a wish. Count to three.
Come with me, and you'll be in a world of pure imagination. Take a look. And you'll see into your imagination.
Welcome back. Here on the panel, we are all avid Netflix watchers, so we're going to be going through our top Netflix picks. My Netflix picks are both crime shows. I love crime shows because whenever you only get an hour to watch something, you felt like you've watched an entire movie, and if you miss an episode, you can just come back and it seems like you haven't missed anything. And my first favorite show is CSI Miami. I wish Horatio Caine was actually a detective in real life because he would be amazing. What do you guys think?
I want him solving my mysteries. For
yes.
If I get murdered, that's who I'm going to call.
Yes.
I just want him to just bring all of the zingers, everything he's got in his back pocket, just unleash him among the mystery.
Yeah.
And my favorite character is Callie, because she just really, I don't know, she empowers women, and she's so strong, and she's all, I don't know, she's just amazing.
She definitely has a heavy hand in that show.
Yeah,
and,
for sure.
I mean, I think a lot of CSIs have a lot of kind of lesser women, but she definitely kind of takes the cake.
And she's one of the few principal characters that is there from the beginning and doesn't get killed, which is a pretty big deal in this show.
That says something about her character, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
She's so strong, she doesn't die.
And then my next favorite crime show is NCIS. And I'm really loving this new season where they added Bishop, because Ziba just wasn't exactly my favorite. So I really like the new blood and how they're always mixing it up. What about you guys?
NCIS is almost like the crime show now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I watched a little bit. I know my mom loves it. I think Mark Harmon's pretty cool. I think he does a good job as Jethro, the kind of the leader.
Mm-hmm. Jake, what are your picks?
My favorite on Netflix as of now is the animated series BoJack Horseman, which is just a beautiful mix of comedy and darkness.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty twisted. I really enjoy watching that, like, you know, just it's my late night show along with Bob's Burgers, so.
I don't think I've ever, like, laughed and kind of, like, internally wept while watching a show before that BoJack Horseman brings that
Indeed, on. It's almost unexpected if you don't know anything coming in.
Yeah, if you think it's a comedy, you're going to be upset.
You're in for a trip. You're in for a trip.
What do you like about it so much?
I just love how real all the characters are. Every single character is just deeply flawed. It's almost like none of them have an upside at this point.
Oh, man, it's all down.
All they ever do is drag each other down. And I just like how sarcastic and how cynical it is of the whole Hollywood scene and the whole 15 minutes to fame.
Yeah.
As well as the whole show is filled with animal puns, which I...
Classic.
They're so cheesy, I laugh every time, and I'm not ashamed.
Yeah, we're a grown man and a horse are... having a drink together and nobody says anything.
It's perfectly normal.
Why the long face, maybe.
Yeah. Always great.
Ambrosia, what are your picks?
My top picks have to be Portlandia. I'm a big Fred Armisen, Carrie Brownstein fan. I just love that show. I can't get over like the guest appearances they had. They have Justin Long playing Lance's son.
Yeah.
And they altered his voice, even though he's a male.
I saw that. That was really weird.
I was like, why is his voice deeper?
Hello, how are you?
And he's like with like her mom. I just thought that was crazy. But my other pick was a movie. It turned out to be 13 Sins, which is a very, very dark movie.
Yeah.
It's basically about kind of you get a phone call and out of nowhere, they'll be like, you'll win $1,000 if you eat a fly. And if you do that, then you get past the next level, and the next level is even more twisted, and the last level just so happens to be to murder a family member. It's incredibly twisted, but it's a really good film. It's probably I'm really big into like twisted dark. I like the happy ending. The ending was like really intense. It was he ended up having a happy ending. You know, he beat the odds of the game, even though he completed every task, he lost all the money, which was $6.2 million.
That's really hard to do, to have a good happy ending.
Right,
or kind of a good resolution to like a horror film.
Yeah, I mean, still end it on a solid note.
Yeah.
I mean, he still was fired from his job, had a wedding to worry about and a child on the way, but you know, at the end of the day, he was not filthy rich for doing 13 bad things.
Yeah.
So that's a win-win.
Ambrosia, what would you do if you were playing the game?
Oh man, like I would immediately do what his wife did. I would be like, that's vile to eat a fly, and just hang up the phone.
Can I just eat the fly and then get out of the game?
No, you have to like, once you like, you start it, you have to continue.
Is $6.2 million not enough?
Man.
I'd probably bring out some bargaining tactics, see how high I can get.
It's like Deal or No Deal with like Sins.
Oh man.
Yeah.
Preston, what are your picks?
I have two shows, and then you kind of mentioned earlier, Bob's Burgers. I'm kind of late to get on that train, but it doesn't get funnier. It's just, it's satire. It's like the kids on the show.
The kids crack me up.
Oh my gosh, the kids are like, unstoppable.
They get me.
What made you decide to start watching it?
I'm a big fan of H. Sean Benjamin. He does the voice of Archer, and now I saw him on Bob's Burgers and I watched it. I fell in love with Tina, the daughter.
Would you say she's your favorite character? Who's your favorite?
Yeah, I'm going to say Tina.
Yeah, Tina's my favorite character.
She's a popular favorite.
She's weird and she's expressing her crazy 13-year-old mind.
So. I know, she's insane. Just some of the things that come out of her mouth. Like, she is not ashamed to say anything she's feeling right now.
Yeah. And then the other show I've been watching, and just in time for Halloween, is Bates Motel.
Good.
It makes the hair on the back of your neck stand up.
How do you feel about Norman?
That show, he's so messed up, and he looks like a nice little kid.
I know, just that sweet boy face goes back to when he's playing like kid roles every time I see him.
Yeah, and if you guys have seen Psycho, it's the storyline, the prequel to Psycho. And you learn why a grown man would keep his mother's corpse in a house for a few months.
Psycho is one of my all-time favorite movies, and Bates Motel does a really good job of keeping with the spirit.
I mean, I think everyone knows like the stabbing the shower scene. So it's so iconic. I mean, I had to watch it.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
So how many hours a week would you guys say that you watch Netflix? Is it definitely like a study distraction?
I don't even have cable in my apartment, so it's pretty much Netflix all day, every day
Netflix,
when I'm not in class.
Hulu, HBO Go, I have them all. It's really bad.
Yeah.
It's my life.
And with the internet, I mean, even if it's not on Netflix, there's still some place to watch it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Anything you want to watch, you can find.
And luckily in our apartment, they left on Hulu the password key in, so we've got everything there. So, yeah, you can definitely watch
it.
Yeah.
But I mean, I try not to watch too much. I have studying.
We never just set a number. We're just like, oh, you don't want to know.
Yeah. You don't set a number. You end up sitting there for hours without realizing it.
They should make a study tool like your professors can see how much you've been watching Netflix.
And coming back, we're going to have some shows that we think should be on Netflix. So we're talking about what we think should be on Netflix. But first, Nightmare on Elm Street is coming off tomorrow, which I think is a really weird decision considering now it's October. It's finally Halloween month when everyone should be watching scary movies.
Yeah.
So why would they take this off?
Well, they're adding a lot of new scary movies. I saw they're adding Scream, I'm not even sure which Chucky movie this one is. It's not one of the most popular ones we've even seen.
But Nightmare on Elm Street is like...
It's classic.
It's one of like the top five like slasher films. Like, you don't go out on Halloween, you get some popcorn, you scream a little bit. It's tradition.
And you just don't get good slashers anymore.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, right.
Nowadays, they're all cheesy prom nights, Lost in the Woods.
Like,
Nightmare on Elm Street is one of the more solid ones.
Yeah. What would you guys want to replace it?
Ooh.
Ooh.
I'm a huge fan of the movie I Know What You Did Last Summer.
Classic.
Right along there with Scream, but I am very much Jennifer Love Hewitt, always a classic.
Mm-hmm.
American
yeah.
Treasure. Mm-hmm. I hope they put that movie on soon.
Oh yeah.
If they put like all the Final Destinations on there,
mm-hmm.
that's when they would sell me on terror.
See, those scared me.
That scared
me. Like, I'm not really worried about a slasher, but like a crane coming loose and like squashing me.
Right.
Like,
or
it's
like
finding the most realistic
up.
Ways.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-mm.
Oh yeah.
Or the roller coaster.
If there were cannibals on there, I couldn't do any movie with cannibals. So that would freak me out. That would be too realistic for me. Like The Green Inferno. But anyway, are there any other shows that you guys think should replace it? In a different genre, I would say that maybe Game of Thrones would be a good one because I have not seen it and everyone's always telling me you have to go back to the beginning, you can't watch it in the middle. Well, now would be a chance to watch it.
You have to watch Game of Thrones.
Yes.
I even wore my awesome
you
Game
understand
of Thrones.
Why I had to kill it.
Gotta see it.
Well, I mean, come on, it's such a great show. If HBO ever allows Netflix to get on that, I think they could dramatically boost their viewers.
What does your shirt say, Preston?
This shirt says Red Wedding Survivor. I'm not going to give any spoilers.
So, you know,
please
you
don't.
Didn't survive to your
but, but the Red Wedding is not something good.
Oh, no, it's not anything great. Honestly, I would have came in my Game of Thrones gear. I have my Jon Snow shirt, but we ain't going to say nothing about that.
I would love to get started on that show. I wish they would have put it on Netflix.
Yeah.
What do you guys think it would take to get it put on Netflix?
Money?
A lot of money.
Yeah. I would say probably an exorbitant amount of money.
Yeah.
Would probably work.
I can't imagine how much that show has generated. I know they already like win all the awards, and I mean, it's just, I couldn't imagine how much it takes to make that show.
If Netflix wants to start like a GoFundMe,
I'll give $5.
Yeah, I'll donate $5 to that.
Right?
It's definitely worth it.
Throw some change.
I mean, what if they put Golden Girls on Netflix? That would be a cute one to watch. I feel like everyone kind of passes over it because they're older, but I mean, hey, Betty White's in it. Like, why not? Why not give it a shot?
If Golden Girls gets put on, my grandmother might sign up for Netflix. So that's one more customer right there.
You can say it's for older people, but I have seen a few episodes, and I mean, it's definitely funny to someone, like to a millennial, so. And I mean, Betty White, can she not be funny?
Right,
like,
it's a great late night show.
Who's your favorite Golden Girl?
I can't believe anybody would not say Betty White.
Yeah. I can't say anything else but Betty White. Sorry.
That might just be our generation, who knows? Like, maybe the older people find favor in somewhere else, but.
Right.
Yeah.
Betty White.
I would really love to see the Divergent movies on Netflix, because I mean, Hunger Games is already on there. I just kind of feel like, why is Divergent not on there? I want to see Shailene Woodley. I want to catch up for the next one coming out sometime.
Yes.
Yeah. I really like those movies. I'm not really a fan of the dystopia, but Hunger Games and Divergent, they're pretty good.
Very well made.
I definitely sit down and watch those on Netflix.
I think Divergent, if it was on Netflix, would probably be the most streamed in
week.
Oh, yeah. Just a matter of days, probably.
Like, oh, I think the most streamed would be Harry Potter. I do not want to have to wait for the ABC Family Marathon.
Yes.
I would love to catch it on Netflix.
That is the best idea. Like, put all the Harry Potters on there.
Yeah.
Goodness. That would be amazing.
I think if Netflix just stops taking away good shows.
Right.
And
yes.
just keeps
Always.
Everything good on there. Mm-hmm. I mean, they took South Park away. I'd love to see more South Park.
They took Dave Chappelle away. The Chappelle show was golden.
Close to home.
Like,
yeah.
Why?
I almost wrote Netflix an email about that.
Oh, you know what? I would
strongly
join.
Worded.
I would write a letter, okay?
Mr. Chappelle.
Bring it back.
And that. I was literally on season 5 in the middle of 24. I was about to find out who the terrorist was, and then they took it off. I had to go find it on DVD. Just no. I think that somewhere they should have a bigger warning of when this stuff is going to come off, so
like
that way
countdown?
I can make sure.
That
countdown.
Yeah. Like
so I can really binge watch it and know, you know, okay, I only have this long and I'm not going to get caught in the middle of the season.
They should put it in time of episodes. Like, you can only watch 32 episodes back to back without standing up or going to the bathroom. Like, oh, I better get on that.
And I mean, why do they have every season of The X-Files but they don't have the movie? What's with that?
I'm going to be the one to speak out. That movie is not good.
Ooh.
That's why they don't have it.
Ooh, it's fucking noise over here.
But they are doing an X-Files reboot with David Duchovny and Agent Sully, because I can't think of her name. So I'm excited.
Gillian Anderson?
Yes, Julia Anderson. So when that comes out, hopefully Netflix will gobble that one up.
Definitely give that a check out.
Are there any other shows that you guys think should be on Netflix that aren't already?
Key and Peele.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now
that it's found it on Hulu and it just needs to transfer to Netflix.
Now that it's being canceled, it's probably have a higher chance of making it onto streaming.
Oh yeah.
True.
But I'm also really excited. I think both of them, Keegan-Michael Key especially, are hilarious. So maybe with all this free time, we're going to start seeing them in a lot more movies.
Right.
Yeah.
And
man,
all they do cameo appearances all the time.
They do a lot of
everything.
Cameo
they're like
I'd
just
love to see
everywhere.
I'd love to see Keegan-Michael Key lead a movie.
Yeah.
He did that teacher movie.
He did, yeah.
Did
that
you guys
was,
see that? It wasn't nothing like I thought it was going
to
be.
I don't think it was supposed to be a comedy, but I mean,
I saw him and thought I was going to laugh and then watched it and didn't laugh at all.
Yeah, that movie was pretty real. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So what about The Simpsons? Would you guys like to see The Simpsons come back? Like, or at least come
I'm not sure if that would be good for my health.
Oh, no.
With 28 seasons.
Yeah.
How long would it take me to binge watch all of that?
It's like, okay, guys, don't talk to me for 9 months. I'm not pregnant. I'm just going to watch all of this.
No way.
But, I mean, I don't think anyone has that much time to sit down.
Don't they have, 550 episodes?
Yeah. Something to the point where, like, I get nervous thinking about watching all of them.
Yeah, you want to keep track of it, but 500 shows, like, that's not even realistic to
Seriously,
watch.
Seriously, Netflix would crash, like, trying to upload it all.
Yeah.
I think people would sign up for new accounts. Just be like, got to get that Simpsons crave going.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So next week's episode is going to be all about cartoons. Do you guys have some favorites?
My personal favorite cartoon growing up was Ed, Edd n Eddy.
Oh,
yes.
I don't know if we have any fans out there, but I actually watched a few episodes the other night in a little flashback.
Yeah, I was there. It was great.
And you know, what'd you guys think about Johnny Bravo? That was my stuff.
Yes.
I like Johnny Bravo.
Johnny Bravo is great.
I like Courage the Cowardly Dog.
That was
creepy cartoon.
Looking back on it, you didn't realize how messed up it was.
You didn't realize how twisted it was.
As an adult, I'm just, why did my parents let me watch that? I don't know.
You're just watching cartoons.
Yeah, Tom and Jerry.
And more about this on next week's show. You can follow us on Twitter at Razorback Reels. So get ready, because next week is going to be a super awesome cartoon-filled show.